Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on a ticket moderator feature and a remove slash command that will remove users from a ticket. So we'll be building on the past code that we wrote in past videos. So let's demonstrate. Let's create a ticket. And a ticket has been created. As you can see, the ticket moderator role has been added to this ticket. And for instance, we can add a user. And they've been added to the ticket. We can remove them. And they've been removed from the ticket. And if we give them ticket moderator, they've been re-added to the ticket. And if we try to remove them, it'll respond saying this user is a moderator. Okay, now let's go to our code. Okay, now we're gonna work on the ticket moderator role. In my case, I'm only going to be using this bot in one server, so I can use a client variable to hold my role. If your bot is going to be a public bot, I'd recommend using either JSON or a database to hold the message ID of the ticket launcher, so where this ticket launcher's message is, so you want to store that message ID in a JSON or in a database and with the associated role ID. So essentially in your ticket slash command, you can add a input called role that will accept a role, and then that role will be your ticket moderator role. So in your JSON, you could have something like this, where you have a dictionary and then you have your message ID as the key and then your role ID as the value, and then your role ID here. So let's get the role ID really quickly. So this is my ticket moderator role ID. So what you would have is the message ID and then the role ID. And if you don't want to do this, you can also use a database, or if you really don't want to do either of those, you could hypothetically attach the role ID to the footer of this embed. So the embed that's created here, if you need support, click the button below and create a ticket. You could do embed.setFooter, and then you can have the text as the role ID. So if we were to have a role input, we could set the text to its ID. So essentially, every single time someone creates a ticket, you'll want to check the embed's footer and then get the role. But since my bot isn't a public bot, I can just use a client variable to hold my role. Okay, so this is my ticket mod client variable. It holds an integer, which is our role ID. Okay, now let's work on our ticket launcher callback. So basically, we want to check and see if this variable, ticket mod, is not a role. If it's not a role, then we'll get the role, and then we can add them to our overwrites. Okay, so what this is gonna do is that we're gonna check and see if ticket mod is not a role. If it's not a role, then we'll get the role. Okay, now let's add them to our overwrites. Okay, so what I did was I added ticket mod to our overwrites. So they have view channel, read message history, send messages, attach files, and embed links permissions. So I also added read message history to our user. And now we can mention them in our channel.send. Okay, now that we're done with channel.send, we can do a try except for channel creation. If channel creation fails, then we can respond saying we couldn't create a ticket and to make sure that the bot has managed channels permissions. Okay, now let's work on our remove slash command. Okay, so I duplicated the add slash command and changed it to remove. So what we'll want to do is we'll want to see if the ticket mod client variable is not a role. If it's not a role, then we can get the role and then we can do some checks. Okay, so we checked and see if ticket mod is not a role. If it's not a role, then we'll get the role. Okay, now let's check and see if the person who initiated this slash command has ticket mod. If they don't, then we'll say you aren't authorized to do this. Okay, so what we do here is we check and see if client.ticketmod, if the role is not in the user's role. If it's not, then we'll say you weren't authorized to do this. Okay, now let's check and see if this user here, the mentioned member, has ticket moderator. If they do, then we'll say you can't remove another moderator. If they don't, then we'll remove them from the ticket. Okay, so we check and see if ticket mod is not in the user's roles. If it's not in the user's roles, that means they're not a moderator. And then we can set their overwrites to none. So this will remove them from the ticket. And then we'll say that they've been removed from the ticket by the person who initiated this slash command. Okay, now let's do an else. And that means that the ticket mod was in the user's roles. That means they're a moderator. And then we'll say you cannot remove a moderator. Okay, so that's about it. Now let's run our code. Okay, now let's go to Discord. Let's create a ticket. And a ticket has been created. As you can see, ticket moderator. So FBI is here too. So if we remove ticket moderator, they've been removed. And if we add, they've been added to the ticket, and we can remove them. Uh-oh, looks like we have an error. Okay, so looks like we have a error called value error and null permission called overwrites. Oh, okay, so we just remove overwrite, or the S in overwrite. Okay, now let's restart our bot. And let's try to use remove again. And they've been removed from the ticket. If we give them ticket moderator again, they've been re-added to the ticket. And if we try to use remove, it says they're a moderator. And if I remove my ticket moderator, and I try to use remove, it says you aren't authorized to do this. Okay, now let's close our ticket. And that's it for this video. So we'll be working on some more advanced things later on in the series. I think we'll be working on some cooldowns, button cooldowns, transcripts, amongst other things. Okay, so thank you for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment down below or join our Discord. Link is on screen. And if you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It'll really help out the channel. Thanks for watching.